down the, my top 38 Rhythm Heaven games. Why is it 38? Because I did not include the second versions of everything. But I did include Remix 8, 9, and 10 in this. So now I'm going to go over which ones are my favorites and which ones aren't. So, for my least favorite one, which is going to be number 38, it is Love Rap. The only reason why I have it here is because if I didn't, everybody would be angry at me, and yeah, I just have it there for that reason. I don't have anything wrong with it, but everybody else does, so I'm just putting it there. And now for number 37, we have Seesaw. I don't hate it. In fact, I actually like it. I mean, I like the whole entire level and that. But the reason I do not like this level is because it throws in something that they didn't tell you about. Yes, other levels do that, but it doesn't go to the extent this one did. When it's a major part of the whole entire level that they don't show you, that's not fair. And that's why I actually failed one time. Because I wasn't aware that they threw that in. They threw the high jumps in. So, yeah. Now for number 36, we have Shrimp Shuffle. You know, I don't really know why I hate this level. I just do. The music, I love it. And that is really all I like about this level. I don't know if I hate the shrimp about it. I don't understand why. I just don't like it. Now for number 35, we have Screw Bat Factory. Why do I not like this one? It's boring to me. I hate the music. I hate the overall gameplay. It's just, I don't find it interesting. Just hold A and B for the right amount of time and then let go. Fun. Yay. See, the second one was a lot better. I mean, at least that added light elements where you would have to realize on your auditory cues and not the visuals. Now for number 34, we have Tambourine. Why did I put this here? I hate Simon Says. I hate Simon Says. And also, it is one of the most precise ones in this entire game. Literally, get 1 nanosecond off, you're marked. You're done. Now for number 33, we have Working Dough. Again, I hate Simon Says, but this one has better music to it, so it gets a pass. It goes slightly above where Tambourine was. For number 32, we have Flock Step. Why don't I like this one? Well, for one, take away the F, and it's Lock Step, but a lot easier. And we've already have another level just like this in the same column. If you don't know what that is, it's Flipper Flop. You have already one of those, so why do they include another one? I don't know, but that's the whole entire reason it's here, because the game already has one in the same column. Add it to a different column, and I would have been okay with it. Now for number 31, we have Catch of the Day. Why don't I like this one? Music good, except I am very bored with this one. I found myself getting bored very easy, and I didn't find any enjoyment to this. I don't know what made me not like it, but I just really didn't enjoy it at all. Now, to number 30, we have Figure Fighter. Why don't I like it? The main thing is the music. I did not find the music very good, and that's about it. That's the only reason why I don't like it. The music. I actually was struggling with this one until I realized that it's actually rhythm. So yeah. Now for 29, which will be the last one of the ones I dislike, I need to throw a remix in there. So Remix 5, why don't I like that one? The music's good, but again, the Flock Step and the Flipper Flop basically hold it back, since I can't decide which one is gonna be the Monkey Watch of the series, of this column. So yeah, Make a choice. Do you want one or two? Or do you want one or none? Because you can't have two in one column. Now, for the ones I don't dislike, we have 28, which is micro row. I like micro row. It's simple, but music didn't exactly hold up for me, but it's not horrible. It plays solid, and I like it. Gameplay's fun. I mean, yeah, I don't hate it at all. For number 28, we have Built to Scale. 27, we have Built to Scale. Why do I like Built to Scale? Well, I like it. I mean, it's very solid. I like the building the widgets, and yeah, it's fun. And it speeds up over time. I like that. I mean, it's simple. It's a very simple game, and good for newcomers. It should have just been earlier in the game, not on the third column. But yeah, I'm fine with that. For number 26, we have Board Meeting. The only problem I have with this one is that it's too short. And I get it, it's only really two things you do in this game. But why is Board Meeting short, but Monkey Watch isn't? So that's my real claim at that. Same with Forklifter. It only has about three things to do, and they're just different amounts of peas. So yeah. For number 25, we have Packing Pests. I like this one. I enjoyed the music, but it wasn't very memorable for me, and I didn't go back constantly to play it. I just didn't find much enjoyment in it. Now, for number 24, we have Launch Party. I don't know what I don't like about this, but I just didn't like this nearly as much, and I think it mainly is the fact that there's four you need to think about, and the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. I couldn't get the hang on that, so I didn't really like it. So that's really what held it back, honestly. If that was different, then I'd probably give it a higher score, but that's about it. Now for 23, we have Bossa Nova. Very nice. I like this level because of the calm atmosphere of this whole entire level. I honestly enjoyed it. I enjoyed the level very much, and the calm atmosphere was great. I loved it. It sounded wonderful. So yeah, that's why it's there. That's why it's at 23. For number 22, we have Remix 2. What else can I say that I haven't said before? The main parts I didn't like was the tambourine section, and that's what kind of held it back for me. The whole tambourine section, because it was very specific on this one. It took me a while to perfect it. So, yeah. That's why it's at 22 and not higher, because of the tambourine sections alone. Now, for 21, we have Remix 10, and I only put it there because I couldn't find anywhere else that was fitting for it. I mean, seriously, it's not spectacular by any means at all, and around the halfway mark seems like a good place to put it. So yeah, that's why I put it there and not somewhere else. Just felt fitting, I mean, seriously. Actually think it wouldn't be there. It would be 19, wouldn't it? Yeah, well, I wasn't gonna put it at 19. Okay. Now we are at 20. For 20 I put Cheerleaders there, and I enjoy this level very much. Just didn't find myself going back and forth to it because there was way too much to remember. But I feel like I felt amazing once I actually perfected it. But there's a lot to it, so yeah, that's kind of what held it back. There was way too much to think about. Yeah. Now for 19, we have Forklifter. Music is amazing, and it really was great in this game. This was probably one of my favorite minigames to play in the second remix. Or the second column. I enjoy this very much. In fact, I've got the handle of it very very quickly, and I just did it immediately. It was fun to do. Really had me feeling the groove, and yeah, that's why I liked it so much. I mean, it was fun. Now for 18, we have Exhibition Match. For the fifth column, it was actually very surprising that this one was in it, because it was very simple. But from what we had very complicated minigames, so kind of give us a little break from all the complications and give us that. So the placement was everything for this level, and I really am happy they put it there. So yeah, this is why this is one of my favorites. Now for 17, we have Monkey Watch. I spent hours on this level alone, trying to perfect it, get a superb, and all of that. For all the levels I did, this one really has you test your rhythm in a true fashion. And honestly, I have to give props to them that they put a hard level in so early in the game, but a little bad placement if you ask me, because it was very early in the game, and I do not hate this level. I love it to death. So yeah, that's why I like it so much. I love this level, and it remains one of my favorite. Now for 16, we have Ringside. Yeah, this is the one which caused all the memes to happen. But you know what? I'm happy about it, because this one was amazing, and I am happy that I got to do this. I loved this one very much, and it was fun. I actually enjoyed playing this one because of the music and all of that, and it was easy to get your handle of, and yeah, it wasn't very challenging at all. Actually, that was the big drawback. It wasn't challenging at all. For number 15, we have Remix 4, this got to be one of my favorites in the game. The main reason why I like Remix 4 so much is a simple reason. That is because it is samurai themed, and I love that. So now, for number 14, oh god, why did I put that there? We have Remix 8! Oh god, I'm gonna get hate now. Just hold on to your pitchforks. I will give you the reasoning why I put it here. This song is very overrated, in my opinion. And it definitely does not deserve the praise it gets. Sure, it's good. It's a good remix, don't get me wrong, but there are better things to the game than just Remix 8. That's not the best thing this game has to offer, by any means. So yeah, that's why I put that there. Now for 13, we have Flipper Flop, the adorable one, which saved that. I think that if it was anything else, I would have just put it earlier, but it had those little cute seals which actually saved this one to be here at number 13. So yeah, you saved your own life, Flipper Flop. What can I not say about this? There's no breaks, nothing like that, but it's still fun, enjoyable, manages to be one of my favorites. Now for 12, we have Remix 6. I enjoyed this. I mean, shoot, it was fun. Carnival themed, not much to say about it. I enjoyed it, you know. It was fun. Like, I really like the part where it kind of sped up with Bossa Nova. It kind of synced with Bossa Nova and Launch Party. That was a very nice one. Okay, for 11 we have Donk Donk, and the reason I put this so high was because of one part in the thing entirely, and that was because the one part where you can't see yourself, and that is because then you cannot use visual cues and you have to use auditory cues or use what you learned, because if you don't, you're gonna get that try again and you will not be happy. I fell victim to it first time. Now for number 10, we have Hole in One. Holy crap, this level is one of my favorites for every reason. First off, nails the tutorial. A tutorial level that is fun and has everything to it. It's hard to get the first time, but once you do, it is one of the best levels with the best music in the game. And that is why it is in the top 10. At this point, it is in the 10 favorites. Now for number 9, we have Tap True. Why do I like this one? It is one... I think this is one of the most challenging levels in the game. Tap Troop is the most challenging level, is one of the most challenging levels in the game, and that's why it is here. I love being challenged, and I love the feeling of, hey, I perfected that. Now for number 8, we have Samurai Slice. The whole reason why, I was very surprised when they added the story to it. The story to it, it was very innocent, and I liked that. It was a very nice story, it wasn't... And honestly, this was probably one of my favorites. And the story, and I liked how whenever you messed up, the story changed. Like, there was one ghost, there was one, like, spirit demon, whatever, and then you miss one. Oh, there's 3 now. Yeah, I liked that. This one. Just adding insult to injury. So for number 7, we have Remix 7. Wow, I didn't realize that. I put 7 at Remix. I put Remix 7 at 7. Okay, why did I put Remix 7 here? The great music in this. I liked the tech. I liked the disco theme to this one. I liked it. I mean, it was a great song, and I liked how those shrimp were finally fried. For the first time. They got what they deserved. And honestly, I loved how they synced it up, and oh my god, the Tap Troop. That was horrible. But it was a fitting final remix until you got to the actual repeats. It was fitting. It made you have a challenge, and it was fun. Now for number 6, we have Remix 3. Why did I put this here? Oh my god, I remember this one. Song's wonderful. I mean, I love it. And very great transition between Figure Fighter and Air Rally. For how much I don't like Figure Fighter? Figure Fighter actually pulled itself through in this one. But that's not Figure Fighter, that's Remix 3 that did it. And honestly, I loved it. I loved Air Rally, I loved the song. And if you... And they actually made like a custom anime opening to Rhythm Heaven 2, the song that's in Remix 3. So yeah, that's amazing. And really happy for that. It's really well made, so yeah. Now we are at my 5 favorites. So, my true 5 favorites. So for number 5, we have Remix 1. For the first remix, this one has the single-handedly second best soundtrack in this game. Loved it. I loved the soundtrack to this one. And it was always wonderful to listen to it every time I restarted the game. To be rewarded with this song, knowing that I did something good until you go to the... And it was a nice little chill thing, and then you realize, hey, until, you know, when you got to the next column, it was like, hey, yeah, you suck. Now, for number 4, we have Karate Man. What can I say about this one? I don't want to bring up the second one, but I have to. I liked this one, especially. I liked the music, I like how fast it was, I loved that. I loved how fast it was, because you had to be like, you had to keep on keeping that groove, and if you didn't, and I loved how it just stopped occasionally, and then it went back, it was keeping you on your toes the entire one, and it was a perfect final minigame. Until the remix, it was perfect. Now, number 3, we have Air Rally. Oh my god, Air Rally! I think I actually cried the first time I heard this one. Oh crap. Yeah, this one was an amazing song. This was one amazing song. I loved it. I loved it in every aspect. It had the best... Even today, I think this is my favorite song to the game. Because of how happy it is. In that genre of music. I keep on going back to it, and I love Forthington. It kind of gives me that feel of DJ School in the Rhythm Heaven game. It's such a happy song that I love so much, and I love to play it over and over and over again. And even though, and it was a challenging level, it had distractions, it had you rely on audio cues and not your visual cues. It was amazing. It had everything. It was an amazing level. Now for number 2, we have Remix 9. Why did I put Remix 9 here? Yeah, you're about to give me hate, aren't you? Well, I love this remix. I like the music a lot more than Remix 8. Even if Remix 8 had the one that is in, that is number one, that still doesn't excuse why I love Remix 9 the best. Remix 8 is a lot more depressing, and I don't like that really. I mean, it has some really depressing words in it, and this one really is more cheery, and it really had, and I liked the voice a lot better in this one, and I liked the instrumentals a lot more than the ones I in Remix 8. Yeah, 'cause I'm just a cheery guy. Yeah. Now, I think it's time we go to an honorable mention. Honorable mention. We'll do three honorable mentions, three of my favorites, and we are not including any of the twos except this one. I am gonna say for an honorable mention, Hole in One 2. This one is how you do a sequel. Best one. Best sequel in this game. It made the challenge progress very hard, and I enjoyed that in every aspect. This whole entire Hole in One 2 was why I loved that level. It really made me feel like I was a champ once I perfected it. I think that was one of the first twos that I perfected, other than Working Dough 2, which really, F Working Dough 2. Seriously. That was way too easy. But seriously, Hole in One 2 is how you make a sequel. It's more challenging than the first, and it gives you makes them on their toes. It was a lot faster, and it made me feel like a king once I perfected it. Honorable mention number 2, Nightwalk. Okay. This song is wonderful. It was nice. I enjoyed it very much. And yeah, that's about it. I enjoyed the song. Didn't really enjoy much else, to be honest, but I liked the song. I really liked it. Yeah, seriously, I loved the song in this game. I loved the song in the Nightwalk, and I just enjoyed it. It was very chill, and I just got to jump and sometimes do a front roll, but that was only occasionally. Now for the third honorable mention, all of the extra games. Why did I not include them in this actual list? 'Cause they are not in Rhythm Heaven Fever. They are not part of the main game. Those are called extra games for a reason. And I'm just including them as honorable mentions because they are original Game Boy Advance games, and I didn't realize that Sneaky Spirits was actually playing because I was perfecting each one. I thought I was still in practice. I got a perfect. I superbed it on my first try because I didn't realize we were in the actual game. Yeah, I'm an idiot. Now let's go to the final one. If you haven't guessed already, it is my favorite one. It is Double Date. Why do I love this one so much? Well, I won't tell you. It's not about the kid kicking balls. It is the story behind it. Yes, it is kind of cheap to put a story, some of the storyline into this, but it kind of gave me a relating feeling to this one, and honestly, relating feelings really make me feel weird about this. And it is a cheap way to get a number one spot, but it gave me emotional appeal. Basically, the story is the kid met this girl at a guitar store while he wanted to buy one, but he didn't have the money. He got lessons from her and started to get attached to her. But when he did buy it, he started his own little band. And that's where the story begins. Basically, he talked to the girl. And they met up at the park bench, and he was gonna give her a ticket to the actual concert, but he was too shy to, and he couldn't actually hear the weasels, by the way, until a random ball came through and he kicked it away, and then he said he was kicking away, it was like he was kicking away his feelings, which, sad as it is, in the end, they got together in a typical fashion, and I loved it. I love this level for everything it does, and I love the music, by the way. I love the simplistic gameplay, and it keeps, even though it's simplistic, it is the most fun level I played. I enjoyed it more than anything all the other games had. And this level alone is why I loved Rhythm Heaven. Rhythm Heaven has all these levels, and they all have their own unique story to them, and it has everything you want. This game alone is why I played it. This level alone gave me the reason to why I spent so much time in this game. Coincidentally enough, Double Date was the last one I got the perfect on. And in the end, I checked it out, and that made me realize why I played it and perfected it. I perfected it to learn the story, and also gave me the music that I was kind of sad. It to learn the stories of each character and get me emotionally attached to them and realize why. Why did it happen? If you checked out the Captain Tuck and the Flippers, we can actually see that the whole entire story was in the mind of a Flipper and how the Flipper basically trusted his captain with his life. And he trusted the captain. And yeah, that's all I really have to say. Thank you all for watching my top 38 Rhythm Heaven Fever games. I'll see you next time. And